On the medical watch, the threat of pneumonia. Olympic gold medalist Mary Lou Retton is in the intensive care unit battling what her daughter calls a rare form of pneumonia. How can someone so seemingly healthy as a 55-year-old world-class gymnast spiral into intensive care from pneumonia? Well, joining me now to talk about the risk, when to seek medical attention, and how to protect ourselves is Dr. Catherine Myers, a pulmonologist at Northwestern Medicine's Canning Thoracic Institute. Thank you for being here.
Of course. Hi, Dina.
Hi. Let's first talk about this rare form of pneumonia. I don't think people realize that there were different kinds of pneumonia.
Sure. So pneumonia can really vary in terms of its severity, and there's lots of different things that cause pneumonia. So viruses can cause pneumonia, bacteria can cause pneumonia, and so it can be very dependent upon what's causing the pneumonia and just how sick you're actually getting. And so there's everything from mild pneumonia that I can give you, like a low dose of antibiotics for a couple of days, and you'll be fine, and severe pneumonia, which would actually land someone in the hospital on a ventilator. And so there are different types of pneumonia, and generally anyone in the ICU with pneumonia is considered to be a very severe case.
In fact, we recently had a coworker who ended up in the hospital as well. I think people don't take it seriously enough. They say, wait, you can be in the hospital for this. Can you talk about the threat? Because it really is deadly.
Absolutely. So pneumonia is still one of the leading causes of death worldwide and in the United States generally. It's in the top 10 causes of death in the United States worldwide, essentially every year. And that has been increased with the COVID pandemic, because COVID often can cause versus increase someone's susceptibility to pneumonia. And so it is a really serious threat. And about 20% of people that are hospitalized with pneumonia will end up in the ICU. And actually, pneumonia is the number one reason for hospitalization for adults in the United States, other than pregnancy. So it's more common than people think, and it can make people extremely sick.
You talk about COVID. It's also flu season. It's cold season. I know those can potentially lead to pneumonia as well. Vaccines for all of them, a pneumonia vaccine, a flu vaccine, a vaccine for RSV. Should we be prioritizing them? Should we get them all at the same time?
Absolutely. So I think it's really important to prioritize vaccination. It's the best defense we have against things like pneumonia. And the risks of most vaccinations are much lower than the risks of pneumonia. And so right now, generally what I'm advising my patients to do is, if they're interested in the COVID booster, to get the COVID booster and the new flu shot at the same time, and then wait at least 2 weeks prior to getting the RSV vaccine. And that just has to do with how the vaccines can interact with each other, and also, honestly, how kind of crummy it can make you feel to get several vaccines at once. And so I'm advising all of those for my patients. And then, of course, if people qualify for pneumonia vaccines, generally most people in the United States don't qualify until they're 65 unless they have other lung diseases. That's also a really important vaccine, and it protects against the most common cause of pneumonia.
Would you talk about the symptoms, please, and how we know that it's really bad? We should, one, see a doctor, two, maybe go to the ER.
Sure. So increasing shortness of breath and fevers would probably be the biggest ones. If you're feeling particularly tired, if it's a cold that is continually getting worse rather than getting better, and then any signs of things like confusion or, again, low temperatures can be concerning as well. And so really, anytime you have like a cold or any kind of respiratory virus, those types of symptoms that seem to be getting worse rather than better, is a really good time to seek out medical care, because the earlier you seek out medical care, oftentimes the better. And also, if you are sick with any kind of virus, getting plenty of rest and trying to take care of yourself, that common, advice that we give everyone that we also don't always take ourselves, because we all live in this busy, world, it's really important, because it helps you maintain your defenses against further infections down the line.
Great advice, especially as we enter a very difficult season. Dr. Catherine Myers, thank you so much.
You're welcome. Thank you.